dream you've had for a long time, to finally hear your music on the radio, to see your album in the store. Now's your chance. Cobra Music Distribution gets independent CDs in the hands of radio station programmers and store managers, not just here in Atlanta, all over the country. We'll also include you in Cobra Music Distribution's online superstore, as well as iTunes, Rhapsody, and Virgin Mega, to name a few. It's just $29.99 a month. Find us online at CobraMusicDistribution.com. CobraMusicDistribution.com. Or call 678-760-2107.
Double check if anything was going on tonight. Find a spot where the music's right, so I can jump on stage and tell the story of my life.
So many things are going on, I find the answers in my song.
Got so much frustration inside, and I can't stay indoors tonight. You can free my soul and spirit. Songs of the streets and love, can you hear it? The tale of every day in every lyric, love and heartbreak, baby, can't you feel it? Now that we're vibing right, I feel it's okay for me to open up myself for everyone to see. Tell my story in three-part harmony,
every chord reflecting the heart of me. Many things are going on, I find the answers in my song.
So I'ma sing till the daybreak comes, so y'all could understand where I'm
coming from.
Music can free my soul and yeah, spirit. Songs of the streets and love, can you hear it? The tale of every day in every lyric, love and heartbreak, baby, can't you feel it? Music is my life. Gotta sing my song in order to stay strong. Music is my life. I can't let y'all know this music's in my soul.
This music's in my soul.
Spirit songs of streets and love.
broadcasting from the heart of Georgia. This is Urban America Today, Atlanta. With your host, Shante Coleman and Roy Evans. With entertainment and news from Jennifer Sky and Lionel Donovan. And now, Urban America Today, Atlanta.
Yes, you have to turn it
and
on.
And now, back to Urban America Today.
All right, everybody. Hi there. How you doing?
Hello.
This is Roy Evans. We are not anywhere we normally have been before. You do realize that, right?
Really? I've never been here. Is my mic on?
Yeah, there it is. Now.
Bam. I'm Tara Jackson, known as Madam Money.
This is the lovely, vivacious Miss Tara Jackson. Y'all see I'm trying to get closer, right?
Yeah, okay.
Holla at your boy.
Holla.
And we're doing this thing. We are actually broadcasting live from Ozio's, Little Ozio's.
Little Ozio's.
At 749 Moreland Avenue in Atlanta, Georgia. Mm-hmm. So if you're in the area, come on down, check us out, and you can have some fun. We got a lot of stuff.
They have the best pizza and bruschetta and mozzarella sticks.
What's a bruschetta?
And set up. A bruschetta?
You know, I'm kind of cavemanish. I mean, if it ain't like...
It's like a toasted bread, but with tomatoes and flavored tomatoes and stuff like that.
That sounds like the pizza stuff
that
you get.
See, what had happened when I went to Italy when I was younger, I learned about bruschetta. And when I came back, they imitate bruschetta. I had paella, I had sangria, and everything. I'm traveled.
Yeah, okay. I've been to D.C.
Okay.
And they got some good food up there.
They really do.
Hey, no, but you know what? We definitely have to go through our little setup. So first things first, thank you guys for tuning in. Again, we're broadcasting live from Little Ozio's at 749 Moreland Avenue in Atlanta, Georgia. Urban America Today, we've been out for a minute.
Yeah.
Call your friends. Let them know they can check us out. If you want to get on and see us, you can go to two places today.
Yeah,
two places.
And we're doing this a little different too. Instead of doing it in the afternoon.
Yeah, we're in the evenings.
Yeah.
That is. Yeah, something new.
So there's no excuse. So I had to work.
That's
now,
right. Y'all
now,
home.
Y'all home.
That's right. Y'all home.
Come on out for dinner or something.
That's right. They can get us at myjbn.com/live with lowercase letters, LIVE.
Yes.
myjbn.com/live. Or you can catch us on skycitytelevision.com.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, booyah again.
Oh, we're
another
syndicated. I guess that's what's called syndicated.
We growing up.
Y'all know,
we started a little late. That was me. My bad. As I was sitting here, I realized that I left my power cord to my laptop.
You know what happens.
It happens.
It's like when I got halfway here and realized I forgot my wallet.
Yeah.
At one of my favorite restaurants.
Yeah, because she knew who Little Ozio.
I'm home, and I'm hungry.
But you know what? I ask Tara about places all the time, and every time I ask her, she's like, oh, I know about that. I knew about that. Just like.
Dude, we lived in, when I worked for a credit union long, long time ago before I quit, we were here all the time. We got our food here all the time, board meetings. We went to Little Ozio, so I pretty much know the daggone menu.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, well, I got to send a shout out, you know, thank one of our fraternity brothers, Leon, X in the building. Yeah, yo. Go, Bob.
Hey, Leon.
He came in and he brought me a power cord, so now I'm not sitting here crying, boo-hooing,
because
I didn't get all this stuff. I was crushed. I really was.
To see a grown black man cry.
Yeah, you know, hey, it happens at times. But
that's good.
You know, we're actually, like you said, we're doing some stuff different tonight. So we're actually going to be, you all will actually get a chance to meet Leon. Leon is going to be coming on. He's going to be talking about a program, actually a couple of things that we're putting together that he's going to be bringing to the network.
Okay.
He's also a cast member of What They Say They Want.
Oh, your play.
So he's running ta-da. It's the project now. It's not the play.
Oh, your project.
We shoot the DVD next month.
It's a project.
Yeah. Well, it's always been a project.
You did that. You're going straight to DVD. You did that.
Ta-da.
Okay.
We'll also have Miss Tabitha Stallings, who is another one of the cast members.
Awesome.
Who's going to be coming on, doing some stuff, talking about a show that her and one of the new cast members are going to be doing. They
you
into the whole music scene.
All these cast members, and I even asked to be on the cast.
Yes, you have. We already been there. We did that. We had that discussion, y'all. But okay, you know what? We have been gone for a really, really long time.
I ain't getting no confirmation. Oh, well, the manager needs to talk to him. So we haven't been here for a while. So I guess I'm going to tell you some things that I've been doing. So, let me tell you. I went to NeNe Leakes' wedding. Okay. It was absolutely fabulous. So you all are going to get the inside scoop. So avoiding the fact that it was 2 hours late. But it was absolutely fabulous. NeNe was gorgeous. The dress was gorgeous. Greg is a ham. He always has been, but he's a ham, so you're going to laugh. Everybody was there. There was this one guy, I can't remember what his name is, but he had, it's one of the guys, Housewives of Atlanta. Anybody that watch Housewives of Atlanta? Do you watch Housewives of Atlanta? Okay, nobody here watches Housewives of Atlanta. But somebody that was watching Housewives of Atlanta, there's this guy who is a little bit flamboyant, skinny guy. I think they have their own show. Well, it was quiet when we were waiting for the wedding to start. And then all of a sudden, he walks in, and he has this poof thing on his head. And I promise you, the entire wedding area busted out laughing. It was hilarious. Absolutely hilarious. Other than that, I met so many people, and we weren't allowed to have our phones and cameras and everything, which completely sucked because I can't even prove everybody that I met. I couldn't prove anything. But I saw Jazzy Faye, which I see all the time. I saw all the housewives, including the ones from California. I saw Omarosa. I'm a new Omarosa fan. I met Omarosa, right? And I walked. Omarosa, I said, I am so proud of you, Omarosa. She said, oh, you're so sweet. What's your name? I said, my name is Tara. She said, well, my name is Omarosa.
No, really?
And I said, I know. And she said, well, give me a hug. Judge Mathis, he actually did the ceremony. So I met Judge Mathis, and I was like, Judge, I really so want to take a picture with you right now, but we can't bring in our cameras. So he was like, I know, I can't bring in mine either. But the joy of my night. I sat with, or this, he's a psychotherapist, and he's on TV One a lot. He's a short guy. His name is Jeff Gardier, I think, or something like that.
I don't know.
Jeff Gardier or something. But I now have a crush.
Oh, you do?
He's a short, older, brilliant black man. I have a crush. He's too old for me. He's probably too smart for me, but I don't care.
What is smart.
He sat next to me.
You're and we, hold on, wait, hold on.
And
stop.
We had the best time.
Hold on.
He was so cute. And if my ride, which who will remain nameless, didn't want to leave her early, he was like, well, just stay here because I want to talk to you when I finish because I have the interview with NeNe. And I was like, okay. And then my ride was like, no, we gotta go. What you get for taking family.
You know what we call that back in the day, right? That he's CB and,
hey, he did. He really, he blocked. Because I was a groupie. That was the one time I was a groupie.
You sounded like you kind of were.
That was one time I was a groupie.
Okay, so, it's been a few weeks. We're actually waiting for Shantae to get here, so I'm not sure. I'm kind of, how we do this.
Oh, well, since he's interrupting, I guess I'm through with talking about NeNe's wedding.
Yeah,
but
I
you'll
go.
See it. I was there. Well, don't be mad because I didn't
ask.
Mad because I didn't ask him.
Hello, so why talk about it?
Because I was there, and it was the bomb. Oh, yeah, and I don't know if y'all saw. I don't know if it's on TV yet or whatever, but who's the chick? Candy. She has red hair now. So she had this gorgeous green dress with her bright red hair. The combination was
tree?
No, the combination was cute, but okay. I don't know if the hair was too red or whatever, but I love the fact that she wore red hair because I always wanted red hair. I look good with red hair. I think I would.
For real?
I think I would. Okay. For real.
I don't want red hair. Well, I technically ain't got no hair. No way.
But yeah, on the next note, but that was my little spiel on NeNe's wedding. So all right,
cool.
It was great. We had a good time, and we danced. I danced till my feet hurt and walked out of the hotel.
Barefoot?
Yes.
Oh, you didn't. You did it.
I did that.
Okay.
So did everybody else.
What else besides NeNe's wedding have you done?
I have been doing a lot of blogging. For those of you who don't know what blogging is pretty much writing articles on a frequent basis mm-hmm. on the internet. So I've been sharing a lot of information. My last one, which seems to be very popular, is Exit Strategies, How to Leave Financially Abusive Relationships. So that's been very popular. So a few sites have asked me to start blogging. So I've been actually writing a great deal.
All right.
You know what? We didn't do the thing, so I'm going to go ahead and do it now.
What's that?
You know, if you've got your cell phones, make sure you text out the folks. We gave you the addresses already.
Oh, yeah.
You can either check us out at myjbn.com/live, or you can check us out at skycitytelevision.com, and we'll be on there as well.
So like I said, I've told you about some people. Is your friend coming back? Are we gonna get to meet?
Yeah,
your
he's
friend?
Coming back. He actually is one of the leaders of his band that he has, and they are fabulous. And hopefully, we can listen to a little bit of it.
We'll do that.
But he is coming back, so he can come say hi. Actually, he's just walking in.
He's
so
just coming in. So we'll
yeah,
get him
we're gonna get him
we'll
in
get
a little bit,
a
so he can talk about
we'll
his band,
that.
And we'll
yeah,
do all
cool.
that. And yeah, we're gonna talk about you. Just have a seat. Yeah.
So.
Not here. Over there. We gotta get you.
You know Tara, man. She
yeah, just sit down right there.
You will be good for
away
right
away from the camera, man. So. I'm just saying. You know, it's my time, okay? Haven't had a chance to be in front of the camera in a while. So.
Right, really, though. So, you know, you haven't asked me what I did.
Yeah. So what have you been doing lately?
Just working.
Really?
No, you know, I've been having fun. We've been getting stuff together. Like I said, we're actually going to be shooting the DVD.
Right.
To the movie. We're not going to actually do the, we're going to use the play script, but we're going to shoot it in a movie format. So we're actually going to do that, and then we're going to get ready. You know, the goal again is to start shooting the movie in October is when we want to start with the official movie. But we're going to get this DVD out, man, and have some fun with it.
Okay. Well, you know, I know we're talking about you, and right now it's really about you, but I have to go back to me because it's really all about me. So when do I get a part? I mean,
well, we've had this discussion.
No,
I told
obviously
you.
We didn't.
See, you know what? This is how folks do you.
Obviously, it was not confirmed.
Okay, see, you didn't say confirmed yet. We said conversation. So I'm cool with it. We just because I figured out how I can make it work.
I don't have a script. I don't have a name.
You guys remember Rachel's character? Rachel has a sister named Marcia. Who Tara is going to play her COO or CEO sister, Marcia. And Marcia was like, of the sisters, Marcia was the one who was all popular and everything. And she's the head of the company, but Rachel is the COO. She was a real introverted girl and all that kind of stuff. And
so you pretty much are giving me a character that I'm very familiar with.
Right. See, there you go. That's it right there. She.
Cool.
It's like playing herself. Why don't you?
Hey, this should be easy.
It was either that or Portia. And Portia is
I like the name Portia, but.
Yeah, Portia's the ghetto girlfriend that just won't leave her ex-husband alone.
Well, you know, I can play ghetto. You know what I'm saying? I can do that. You know what I'm saying? Because my man, you know, he may not be the best in the world, but you know, he got my bag. I'm just saying.
No, you dumped him, and now you won't let anybody else get with him.
Well, then, you know how that goes. Ain't nobody have my stuff. Can't nobody have mine.
You know what? I'm going to say hello to somebody who's a new viewer. They just texted me and said they're checking in.
What?
So, yeah. So.
People actually texting?
Yeah.
Hey, if you're on Twitter.
I'm not tweeting. I'm still not tweeting.
Tweet. So you can tweet, too. So make sure you hashtag MyJBN, okay? So
you know, Facebook does hashtags now.
Yeah.
Can you really tell me what's
you could
the point
always,
of the hashtag?
Well, yes, I can. Because.
Oh, wait. Shauna, hey, how you doing? I'm sorry. I was saying hello.
Hey,
say hey to Shauna.
Hey, Shauna. How you doing? Okay, so hashtags is actually a thread. It's a thread of conversation.
Okay.
Okay, so if you hashtag, so one of my famous or most frequent hashtags is IJS. I'm just saying. So if you search hashtag IJS, you can see every post that has that hashtag.
Oh,
so it's just like Twitter. I do Twitter chat. So my Twitter chat is Cash Chat. So if you search hashtag Cash Chat, you can see the conversation that's going on.
Okay.
So you can see everything. So Facebook just incorporated so you can actually search the hashtag. So other social media that uses hashtag really good that you really need to get with is Instagram. you can have thing, yeah, right? You can have people that will like your pictures, whether they like your follow you or not, if you do the right hashtag. So every time I hashtag something, I have like 50 people that like my pictures that are not my friends. So that's a way to build up your social media.
See, I was about to say they go to free social
free,
media kick out.
Free social boom. Media advice.
Tara did it again.
Just saying.
She did that again.
For more consultation, I charge. No, I'm just kidding.
No, she's not. She really does.
No, I'm really serious.
So, yeah, she does do that.
But that's okay. But, okay, yeah, so that's the point of hashtags.
Okay, so what I'm going to go ahead and do.
Take a break?
Well, I'm going to go over there so I can take a break while you tell us about your friend that's coming up.
Oh, so, yeah, I'll tell you about my friend that's coming up.
So I can jump over there.
Yeah, you can hand me the CD so I can really say his group's name. But his name is Mark Kevin Fortson, and he has this awesome band. I've heard him several times. The band is called... What is the band called, Mark? Mark Jones Band. It's even named after him, you see? So we're going to talk to him in a little bit. Mark Jones Band, that's Mark Kevin Fortson. He is going to be here live to talk about some of the things that the band is doing and the type of music. And then hopefully we'll be able to check him out, you know, listen to a little bit of it because the music is awesome. So stay with us. We'll be back. We're at Little Ozio's on Moreland Avenue. So I'll be right back.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoked barbecue chopped chicken or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink, all for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
So the salient features, once more, the GS4200 model. Manufactured than its venerable predecessor, and up to 17% quieter. Naturally, it's available in both. Sorry about that. Grain beige. I'm sorry. I think I'd better take this. It's my wife on Uvu.
Hi, Dad.
Hey, Pumpkin. What are you doing?
I'm Uvuing.
Very funny. What?
Hey, Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Make the money.
Where's your mother?
Mom!
What?
I love you.
I love you too.
On HBCU Sports, host Donna Ware will take you on a journey each week through the world of HBCU sports and pro sports with such guests as...
Let's welcome Serena Williams.
And, of course, Donna Ware's insights.
This will be one of the best matchups ever.
To listen to the show each week, visit us on the web at www.boxtorow.com. From the press box to press row, real sports talk.
Yes, I'm Anthony London, CEO of Sky City TV. We want to invite you guys out to check out the newest, best thing in television. We'll bring you everything from movies, videos, commercials. We are innovating the television network market. We've got things that are going to happen that are going to be big for us. Sky City TV, the best. Come join us. Watch it. Dish Network, we're in the house.
Mm-hmm.
America Today.
Hello and welcome back to Urban America Today. We are at Little Ozio's on 749 Moreland. Is it 749? 749 Moreland Avenue in Atlanta. So if you are out and about, well, if you're out and about, you wouldn't be watching. So if you're home, come on out. We're going to be here for a while. Get some good food. They have some awesome food here. So just wanted to talk a little bit to my good friend, yes, Mark, yes. Fortson of the Mark Jones Band.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Oh, absolutely. So he, you know, he did me a solid. So I'm like, we got to interview him because he has an awesome, awesome band. If you've never heard of them, we're going to talk about where they're going to be performing, what type of music. But Mark, tell me a little bit about Mark Jones Band. How did you format it? No, I want to know, how did you decide to name it? I got to know this. Mark Jones Band. Tell me how you decided to name that.
Well, that's a unique story. What happens is I have a good friend of mine whose name is Jonathan Jones. And okay. So he is a phenomenal keyboard player and organist. So he and I do a lot of gigs together, whatever. Mm-hmm. And so we was going back and forth. Like, if I needed him to come play with me, he would come. If he needed me to come play with him or whatever. So we was going back and forth. And so about 3 years ago, we were doing a friend of mine asked us to do a birthday party for her. She was okay. Like, I want a live band for my birthday. So I said, okay. So I called Jonathan. I was like, hey, listen, we know we're going to do this birthday party or whatever. So we went in, we set up, we started playing and everything. And so we was doing good, and people kept asking us, well, what's the name of your band? What's the name of your band? I'm like, we really don't have a name. It's like, it's just me and him. You know,
okay.
And so I said, it's just Mark and Jonathan or whatever. And I don't know, it came to me. It was like, okay, if it's just me and him, then why don't we just name the band after ourselves? You know, we'll call it, you know, Mark and Jonathan or Jonathan and Mark or whatever. And then Jonathan was actually the one that came up with the Jones. He was like, let's use your first name and use my last name, and okay. We'll put a slash in the middle of it. So it'll sound like somebody's name, but the way it's spelled or the way it'll look on a business card, it'll look kind of unique. So it's okay. Mark Jones.
Okay. You know, what's that rapper?
Mike Jones.
Oh, yeah, okay. But it's a Mark Jones band. Well, that's good. So now it's not just you and Mark.
No.
I mean, you and Jonathan.
Right.
So you've now expanded it to some more people.
So what we did was we picked up a phenomenal bass player. His name is Jarrell.
Right.
Jarrell Northern. But okay. He played with us for a little while, and then he went on to take advantage of some other business ventures.
Okay.
But then we picked up another phenomenal bass player, and his name is Eric, but he's affectionately known as Smook.
Smook,
that's his name. So if you ever find a bass player that's got that one nickname.
Yeah, he's got a nickname, he good.
Yeah, he awesome.
He and good.
Smook is ridiculous on the bass. So, and we started doing, like last year, we started playing up at Skybox Sports Bar and Grill.
Right.
And we picked up a phenomenal singer by the name of Tamaya Willis, okay. Who's still with us.
Oh, good. Okay.
And Tamaya, she had never performed in front of an audience except for church.
Oh, wow.
But she
does great.
Right. She got up there. She embraced it.
She is just as good as I was when I used to sing for an R&B band.
Oh, speaking of which, I'm trying to get this one up here to come and do something, but she won't act.
Shout out to New Approach.
Oh, my God.
Sang an R&B band, but that's another story. This is all about Mark Jones.
I'm trying to get Tara, but please believe if I can get Tara to come and do something with me, I'm going to let the world know.
I might surprise y'all.
Oh,
you know.
We got another surprise
Grace
coming up, though.
The world, I'll see. It was only one try. Okay, well, that's okay. Well,
that's fine. But
well, that's okay. We're gonna
listen. Though. I got a surprise though.
What's the surprise?
I'm bringing in a celebrity vocalist.
What?
Yeah. See, hopefully we'll pick up a gig over at the Shark Bar.
Okay.
Formerly known as
the Pearl
mm-hmm. Bistro. I have a celebrity vocalist that's going to come and be doing some work with us. His name is Anthony Dorsey, and he's formerly of the R&B group Hamilton Park.
Okay.
So I've known him since he was young and everything, and he actually came and did something with the band when we was at Skybox a while back.
Okay.
And he got up there and shut it down. The ladies loved it.
Wow.
And everything. So I said, I definitely got to get you back. So
well, that's awesome. So what are some things are you all going to be, you have any gigs lined up yet? Or
yeah, a lot of what we do now is a lot of private gigs. We got about 4 weddings lined up right
now.
Wow, okay. And we have some other little events and fundraisers that's coming up. We've done 2 fundraisers for the Obama administration, actually.
Really?
Yeah, for the chapter that's based out here in Atlanta.
Okay.
So we've done some work with them. So we got some things coming up, but anything public, you know, open to the public,
okay,
please believe we're going to let y'all know. And we're going to try to secure some weekly gigs and things like that.
Awesome. So if someone wants to book you all for, you know, for a gig or anything, how can they get in contact with you?
They can get in contact with me, Mark Kevin Fortson, at 404-317-2178. Again, that's 404-317-2178. Or you can email me, and check this out. You're going to love this.
What's this?
Play loud, play hard at yahoo.com.
Oh, Lord.
Again, that's play loud, play hard at yahoo.com. Hit me
okay,
up.
That's
and
we're right,
available for anything. I mean, we do weddings, funerals, bar mitzvahs,
you
divorce
said funerals,
parties. We do it all. We do everything.
Bar mitzvahs.
Divorce parties, christenings.
Now that might be something right
circumcisions,
there.
Circumcisions, whatever. We
you
do it
said
all.
Circumcisions. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name.
Yeah, we do it all.
Well, that's good, and we're gonna try to play you. If we can't play you out right here, but we're gonna play you out. So, you know, as a social media queen here, you know, I'm gonna hit him up and try to get them going on
yes,
that because they are that awesome.
Yes.
So everybody needs to know who they are. Yes.
Here it is, the voice of God again, as we like to say, as I come in. You know what we're going to probably need to do once we get back into a regular location?
Yes.
We're actually going to need to have the band come out and do a live performance.
Well, I guess Ta-da, you found your band.
Look at that.
Titty out.
Look at God.
See how God is? Look at that.
Look at God.
See that?
I can dig it. I can dig it.
So, you know.
So we'll come back and feature him. He can bring the whole band out. And we'll
okay,
get everybody down.
So when we start it back up again going, we're going to need some live music.
Oh.
And we're going to have the Mark Jones Band.
And Tara know I'd do anything for her. She
oh, that's so sweet. I might even have to sing a song.
Oh, my goodness.
Maybe.
We're going to get Tara a gospel song to sing.
A gospel? Yes, I need Jesus. It's been a while.
Oh, my.
Pray.
He still loves you.
He still loves me, though. That's okay. Pray for me. Okay, so we're going to play something out and see which one it is, and then we'll be back with Roy.
Quality.
And oh, okay. We're going to play. He's going to play it now. Okay.
We are the Mark Jones Band.
No, we can't really hear it.
This is Epiphany. I can sit in the chair.
Something must be playing, so.
Yeah, I'm listening.
We'll see if something's playing.
We're having some technical difficulties.
Ah,
oh, that makes all the
difference. It helps if there is a plug in there.
It's plugged up.
Hey, Mama's here.
It's over.
No, she did not walk up in here with rollers in her hair. I love this woman.
Night and no roll you to
I'm the only woman.
I'm watching
me.
My
it sounds like that one.
Waiting for it to ring.
Huh?
In the house
oh, he's gonna find out what song
TV
it is.
All
that,
night
is
all alone.
That is Chrisette Michelle.
No, a song.
Yeah,
a song.
That's Chrisette Michelle. Yeah, it's a cover song. It's a cover song.
I say, I'm like, oh, so. So.
No,
okay.
No, that's not.
It's his band.
Oh, I think I'm just about done being your girlfriend. That's the name of it.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to go to break.
Okay.
We're going to let that play. So,
okay, we'll go to break. Listen out. Check it out.
All
thanks,
right.
Mark.
No problem. I appreciate you having me.
Mark and Mark and the Funky Bunch.
Yeah.
It's over, it's over. Second night in a row, you didn't come home. I'm watching. the house on the couch with the TV on, all night all alone, every time the same old thing. So I think I'm just about over being your girlfriend. I'm leaving, no more wondering what you've been doing, where you've been sleeping. I'm leaving, so you walk in the next. Give me some excuse, like you always do. I just kiss your cheek, and this is what I tell you.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoked barbecue chopped chicken or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink, all for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
So the salient features, once more, of the GS4200 model. Faster than its venerable predecessor, and up to, 17% quieter. Naturally, it's available in both. Sorry about that. Grain beige. I'm sorry, I think I'd better take this. It's my wife on Uvu.
Hi, Dad!
Hey, Pumpkin, what are you doing?
I'm Uvuing.
Very funny. What?
Hey, Dad!
What?
Dad!
What?
Dad!
What?
Make the money!
Where's your mother?
Mom!
What?
I love you.
I love you too.
HBCU Sports. Host Donna Ware will take you on a journey each week through the world of HBCU sports and pro sports with such guests as...
Let's welcome Serena Williams.
And of course, Donna Ware's insights.
This will be one of the best matchups ever.
To listen to the show each week, visit us on the web at www.boxtorow.com. From the press box to press row, real sports talk.
Yes, I'm Anthony London, CEO of Sky City TV. We want to invite you guys out to check out the newest, best thing in television. We'll bring you everything from movies, videos, commercials. We are innovating the television network market. We've got things that are going to happen that are going to be big for us. Sky City TV, the best. Come join us. Watch it. Dish Network, we're in the house.
America Today.
And that sounds like that's about the end of it. Hello, we're back.
Hi. Hey. Y'all okay. Caught me trying to get something to drink. That's okay.
Okay, so y'all know we're going to talk about Shantae, right?
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at her.
Yeah. But you know what?
I'm not going to let you talk about my sister.
Wait, hold up. No, but here's the funny thing. I have not seen those rollers since I was like 10 years old.
Oh, yeah. They were the Jerry Curl rollers, but still, they matched her shirt. That's how fabulous that she is.
No, you know what I used to use those for, though? I used to use those rollers that my mom had like that with my little action figures, and I made them like bazookas for my little army men.
You know, it scared me that he actually used them, so I was glad you clarified that.
No. Hold up. Slow your roll.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. I thought he was going to go into when I had hair. No. Okay, just checking.
No.
You never know. This is Atlanta, right?
I'm not from Atlanta.
All right. Just checking.
Let's clarify that.
Okay. Just checking. Right.
So, you know, we didn't do news. We didn't talk about any of this stuff. We were kind of just rambling along because we hadn't seen each other in so long.
We were just so happy to see each other.
Yeah, we got more people showing up. We're going to be interviewing Daryl. He just got here. So, you know, awesome. We're going to be talking to a whole bunch of people.
Cool.
Oh, you know what? You can bring that over here because this is yours, right?
Is it mine?
Oh, is that yours?
The bruschetta. Ah.
Okay, see? So we can let folks see the bruschetta. That's my point. See?
This is the bruschetta. Okay, so it's the toast. With a flavored...
It's bread and tomatoes.
Bread and tomatoes. With mozzarella cheese on it. With a pesto. Oh, it's my favorite.
I'm a dude. That's bread and tomatoes and cheese.
Yeah, and it's the best bread, tomato, and cheese that you'll ever have.
All right. And we are getting at Little Ozzio's.
I don't know why he brought it in front of my face when I can't eat on camera.
That's why I'm doing it, because she got to sit here and listen, so we gotta talk a little bit. But 749 Moreland Avenue. In Atlanta, Georgia.
Yes.
Okay, so let's start. Okay, are we going to start with Paula or are we going to start with the Supreme Court? Which one are we going to start with? See, they're going to tell you already in the background saying
hey,
so.
I'm going to need you to take your rollers out so you can chime in on this one because.
We already went there on you.
Oh, we went there on you, babe.
Yeah,
But I said you were fabulous. I said you were fabulous because rollers. Just put it right there. Your rollers actually match your shirt. That's how fabulous she is. If y'all can just see it, she can do this. She can, like, rock it on TV right now, for real. I wouldn't do it, but she can really rock it. She can rock it for real.
Okay, Tara. Okay. Supreme Court or Paula? Supreme Court or Paula first?
All right. Well,
Let's talk about Paula. Okay. I'm going to let you say what you got to say.
I'm going to let you start.
Because, you know, I'm going to go.
What are we talking about, Paula?
I'm going to go there. But, see, I'm going there on the black folks, so. I'm going to let you say what you want to say first. Please say what you want to say.
I don't really think that Paula is racist. I think she just says some dumb sugar honey iced tea.
Okay.
It's just the stuff that comes out of her mouth is just that Southern ignorance. I think that's what happened. Her crime is being...
being a victim of her time.
Being a Southern ignorant person that is a victim of her times.
Yeah, she's a victim
of her time. I don't feel that she is really racist or anything. She is just from the South, and the South people don't know how we do it up North. You don't say, some of my best friends are as black as this blackboard. You don't say that. Now,
yeah, that was
bitch,
not
that's
the
your
right
fault.
Thing to say.
Okay, so... Because you said that, that was your fault.
She got it in. Okay.
So you don't say that. You don't, even if you did say, they said, well, we never said the N-word at home. No, you just wait until you saw thousands of people to bust out the N-bomb. Bitch, that's your fault. So.
There's children in the building.
Oh, sorry. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, they're children in the building.
Ma'am, that's your fault. But. I have always known her to be a very loving person. From what I see on TV, she does fabulous food. After she stopped putting like 2 pounds of butter on stuff, you know, she repented, turned from her wicked ways, and started cooking healthy. I think she's an excellent cook. I just think that it was just a sign of the times that she just didn't grow out of. But I think, that's hot. I'm mad that he's bringing this food there. Focus. Now, no, like, focus, okay? But with Paula Deen, I think what's going to happen with her is that, yeah, the Food Network is going to maybe ditch her or get rid of her.
They've already done that.
And they did?
Yeah, they did.
But she gonna come back. She gonna come back. People hungry. I'm sorry. She can cook. And people hungry. She's gonna come back. She's apologized. I don't know what else everybody wants her to do. And until African Americans stop dropping the N-bomb, I mean, other people say it. Just like people say honky, people say other things. You know, we say racist stuff too, but it's okay for us to say it, but other people can't say racist things. I'm not saying it's right, but if it ain't right for them, it ain't right for us either.
Okay, so now it's my turn. You can eat some of your bruschetta because okay. I ate some of my pizza.
Thank you.
Another not-so-random thought from my mind, people. Mm-hmm. Hello, is everybody listening to me?
We're listening.
She just said it. I am so sick and tired of hearing black people jump up in arms when they hear somebody white use the N-word, when in every cultural dominated thing that we have, we're using it. It's prevalent in our music. It's prevalent in our TV shows that y'all are putting out. It's all over the place. So if it's, like she said, if it's gonna be wrong for one group of people, you know what? It needs to be wrong for us.
Well, let me.
Hold on, I ain't done yet.
Okay, you ain't done yet.
Let me done. Let me finish. Because see, we've got more issues that we really need to deal with, like our children killing each other.
Yeah.
You know, like the lack of financial circulation of our dollars in our community.
The lack of financial education. Don't get me started.
There you go. I mean, you know, it's just so many other things, and it kills me. And again, you have to take these comments in context. You are talking about a woman that lives and probably grew up in Savannah, Georgia. Okay? Savannah, Georgia. Okay, most of us are like what most areas are probably about what? 50 years out of the civil rights movement.
Yeah, Savannah ain't going nowhere.
Dog, look here. I done been to Savannah. Yeah, they got a college there and everything. But Savannah probably about a good 15, 20 years removed.
Savannah ain't going nowhere.
So they still kind of country back there. And it's still kind of old school. So you, again, have to recognize where that comes from. Now, should she know better? Okay, yeah. Give her a slap on the wrist. All this about people need to lose their job over stuff like that to me is ridiculous.
If people lost their job for some of the dumb crap that people said, there'd be more people unemployed. But I digress. What I did want to say is I was going to do the other side of my statement because I'm an Aquarius and we can look at both sides. Now, I understand why a lot of people are upset with her because it's like if me and my sister are upset and I call my sister the B word and be this or whatever, and I'm talking to someone that does not know my sister, and then they come out of their mouth and they call my sister B word, I'm kicking their butt. Because they can't call my sister that. They don't qualify to call my sister that. They don't know my sister. Nobody else can talk bad about my sister but me. That's the mindset. Wait a minute. Whoa, I'm not done yet. Now, that's what a lot of people are using as the excuse of why it's okay for to use the N-word, but nobody else can. I think it's completely asinine because if we really understood where the term came from, you know what I'm saying? We wouldn't really want to make it an endearing word.
We've had
like
that
you wouldn't
discussion.
You wouldn't make something that something that's blasphemous for a homosexual term or whatever you want to say that's bad to say that. You wouldn't want to make that an endearing term, even though we do use the B word as an endearing term. We make it endearing when we want to make it endearing. I don't know why.
Yeah, but see,
that's a whole other psychological.
But see,
thing.
Here's the difference. This is the difference in that. Because, yes, that is theoretically a slang when you look at it. Okay, the N-word it had one definition from what it started off as, and that's what it was. So, for other, but that whole, you know, don't call me, I'm not that. No, I ain't him. And I let folks know, no, what? I am not your, uh-uh.
Doesn't it stand for ignorant person?
It's an ignorant, stupid person. I actually wrote a note on Facebook for Father's Day. I'm saying something to my dad, and I made reference in that how I got in trouble in school, and he had to come up to school to defend me because I called a little white kid that, and little white kid went home and told his dad, and he came back saying he called my son, and I said, well, he is stupid, you know, and that was the whole deal. But
well,
you know,
I think if we understood what the term really meant,
everybody knows.
But I would be more upset with the fact that whoever she termed it to Well, obviously, she doesn't know what the term means either.
Who?
Spala. She don't know what that term means.
Okay. Yeah, we're going to let you come in because she got a head wrap on. I'm going to actually get up.
Oh, she's
and
then not going
to. I'll become the voice of God
Paula,
again.
Paula, I'm
the
trying
backside.
To help you out, but you know, with the last video that you did where you pulled your friend up and said, well, I have a friend who's as, who's, you know, my bodyguard is just as black as this board.
Right,
you were wrong for that.
That was a mistake.
I'm just saying.
But was
you
he?
Were wrong for that. Yeah.
Okay, well, see, so. Yeah, you shouldn't have said it that
I'm
way.
Saying,
you should
okay,
just been
so
like, here's
okay.
my black bodyguard.
It's okay for me to say, I got a friend, and she's as white she's as white as this cup.
I mean, if she is, the truth is the truth. I'm sorry. Some things you can't get away from. Saying that man is as dark as he is one thing. Calling him the N-word is
well,
a
she was trying to defend
situations.
The fact that she wasn't prejudiced.
Right, she wasn't racist.
So I defend the fact that I'm not prejudiced by saying, well, I have some of my best friends are white.
Right, and that... Okay,
is that okay for me to say?
Let me say
but
something.
But is it okay for a white person to say, well, some of my best friends are black?
Yeah, that just...
That's
they,
okay for them to
they
say,
are,
too?
If it's the truth, it's the truth.
Then why?
And that's what people have to get away from. That's the thing that irks me. Is it if it's true, okay, then let's get going.
Okay, well, we got a lot of time.
I'm going to let Tay... Yeah, because Tay want to talk about this subject,
yeah,
so...
let Tay talk so I can eat some more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Tay, you get to talk because I'm going to take my pizza with me.
Come on, Tay. That's not right.
Yes, it is.
You're wrong for that.
All I'm saying is let the church say amen.
Amen, sister. Amen. See, she put a rap on it.
Amen.
I said you should have had the. You need to bring one of those rollers
I'm mad
out.
At them, and I'm gonna handle them when we get off this.
The
air
rollers. I
with
promise
y'all.
You, it matched her blue.
It did.
She
it
rocked
matched
it.
My blue, but I'm not fooling with them.
Okay,
before you go too far though, make sure you shout out Tabitha who hooked you up there.
Absolutely, and. Y'all going World Trade Center on me. That's what y'all doing. Okay. Well, shout out to my girl, Tabitha, little short cutie pie in the building, who hooked me up with the little rap so I could come and holler at y'all.
You go, girl.
Since they want to, like, straight kaboom me.
I
like,
say you come out.
With World Trade.
I say you do you. What'd
wait,
you say?
Wait,
yeah, that's
what?
Right.
Tabitha Stallings at Twitter.
You know what?
Tabitha
ABC.
Stallings.
Always be selling. You go, girl.
I want you to know that's ABS.
Oh, ABS. Always be selling.
That's always be closing.
Always be closing. Whatever.
Anyways,
she did that. Now talk
okay,
about
so
Paula.
This is what I'm thinking about. Okay, this is my thoughts. I've been considered wrong, but that's fine.
Okay.
First of all, my first thought, and I don't know if y'all said this because I didn't hear this. I heard a lot of what you said, but I'm not sure. Number one, viewer at home of the African-American descent, do you say the N-word? Because I do. So, let's start there.
You know, you say, N, please. I
right.
know y'all said that before.
So,
N, please.
Okay, a lot of them do. A lot of you do. So,
I
for you
it.
To pretend like you are so over-the-top offended by this word itself is a trip to me. Now, number two, I'm sorry. I don't care who you are. I'm personally, if you're sitting in my face with a gun and you're trying to rob me, because if y'all don't know, I'm sure y'all have already discussed that this is how this all came out. She was held up at gunpoint by a man. She was being robbed. That's the one she called the N-word. Yes, that is how this all happened, y'all.
Oh, really?
Okay. Somebody had her up at gunpoint, and she's like, oh, you, right. This is how this happened. So
don't
guess
look,
what?
Don't
I don't care
me,
if he
don't
was
tell me
purple.
The dude that, don't tell me
if you
the
got a gun in my face, you are all kinds of everything but a child of God.
Don't tell me the dude that held her up is suing her.
Yes. and the freaking attorney is here in Atlanta.
Stop lying. Wait a minute.
The attorney is here in Atlanta that is filing the suit.
She gonna make me have to go back and research this.
Okay.
So
see,
are
now,
you saying
that's what I said.
Are you saying that
she was held
some
up
guy
at gunpoint.
Was held up at gunpoint?
No, she was held
she
up.
She was held up at gunpoint.
Yes.
She called him the N-word.
In the right.
Because she was being held
come
up.
Come to find out it was actually somebody who worked in her office. Keep going. Uh-huh.
That was holding her up.
That was holding her up at gunpoint.
Oh, so she recognized it was him and was like, you in whatever. Right. So now...
He could have been purple for all I care. You would have been all kinds of those.
So now, since he couldn't get that much by sticking her up, he was like, you know what? I'm going to get you where it really hurts. I'm going to sue you, boo.
Right.
Wow.
And America is causing this woman to lose everything
that's
she
not
has
right.
because somebody
that's
held
not right.
her. Nobody's even focusing on the point that she was in the middle of being robbed. I probably would have called you all kinds of things but a child of God.
Yeah, that would have been me.
In the middle of being robbed,
I would have called you every name in the alphabet.
Out of her mouth, no, I do not use this word. No, that is not. And that was 30 years ago when this happened,
yeah,
y'all.
And she said,
is anybody not noticing
all
this is 30 years ago?
All they asked was, have you ever used the N-word? Now, if you ask that to any white person, they'll probably say,
yes. Yeah.
Should they lose their job?
Wait. Hold up. Wait a minute. Stop.
Why does he keep talking behind the camera?
Wait. I'm sorry. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I'll even add my camera shot in for this.
Need to see the face.
You just said something that really has me confused.
Right.
Please tell me that this situation did not happen
30 years ago. Yes.
It was a long time ago.
Please tell me that this
was long time ago.
No, I do not want to hear that this was not.
There were some recent things that she said that was stupid. Like,
please tell me this was last week.
No, it was not. Oh,
No. This is something that she's being
several years ago.
She's being crucified for.
From
that happened long time ago.
Years and years ago. Oh, no. It didn't just happen.
From being held up at gunpoint.
She's being sued. So, of course, it's deposition. So she's talking about the past.
Right.
That's where all this came up. Is that she admitted under oath that she used a word many years ago.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
Okay.
That's how
wrong.
This is all coming to.
Well, you know what? I'm sorry. I'm real sorry.
he's like, I digress.
Tay, I'm sorry. This is not to Paula. This is to all of the people who out there who are making this
bigger than what it
issue.
Needs to. Yes.
Bitches, them y'all faults. Right now. I'm sorry.
Did he say it?
That right there.
Did he say it? Go on, say it again.
That right there.
Say it again.
See, that's what I'm saying.
I got to research this because if that's the case.
Say
it
again.
What you
saying? Into all of these facts. How does
bitch, that's y'all fault. For being
almost
that ignorant.
30 years later, she's
because if the term means ignorant, there's a lot of people that are acting very ignorant, and it doesn't matter what color they are. Right about now.
So you'll see why I had to come on.
I'm not justifying what she said and it was right or wrong or whatever. She said it okay, but for her to be crucified like this.
Right. For something that happened decades
years ago,
number one. Number two, it happened at gunpoint.
I'm gonna
somebody
have to
was in the middle
that.
Hold me up. I'm gonna call
to
you all
that.
Kinds of. I'm gonna have to repent on Sunday for some of the things I might call you.
But see, y'all have to understand what the media will do. Media will sensationalize it. They will keep things out of the media, and then they will put certain things in the media.
Which,
so you all can't base a lot of opinions on what you see in the media.
Which,
I'm just
by
saying,
the way, y'all, not for nothing.
Research.
You brought it up to Roy when you were over here that this woman was born and raised in Savannah. Am I justifying? No, mm-hmm. No. What I'm saying is. Some odd 30-something plus years ago? Come on, y'all. Don't act like that wasn't commonplace back when. 50s, 60s, it was commonplace that some of the white people in the lower South were still using that word, even in the public. So let's keep it 100. Thank you. We're talking about Savannah. We're not talking about in Atlanta. We're not talking about in, like, you know, New York or LA or something. This is in Savannah. This
okay, I've had my twentieth bite of my. I'm kind of over the conversation. Can we move on to the next?
We are going to move on. To the next
conversation.
So now you all know some more to the story.
I'm gonna have to research it. We'll have to get back to you on it.
Well, I can tell you this.
I trust what you say, and it's true. I'm just going to verify.
While I was walking over here, I found out she's also getting shot down from Walmart and there was one other. Thing that she has, and they're all shutting her out. They're getting ready to sever ties.
My thing is,
that's
why are we so
bananas.
Focused on Paula when we have other things that we need to focus on, like the Supreme Court? Like,
right,
dude,
the
seriously?
Rulings, the rulings.
Like Clarence Thomas, I'm sure the KKKs are really getting ready to give you a big old high five. Yeah, I said it.
Okay, so since she started there, we'll go ahead and lay that out for everybody.
Right.
I'm glad
there
I
were two
said
decisions.
It. I did. I said it out loud. I said it. Lord knows I said it. I said it.
Say it again.
There are two different rulings, and we'll start with
right,
the one from
right.
yesterday, where the majority of the Supreme Court has stricken down a part of the 1965 Voting Rights Act,
right.
which is now giving Southern states the ability to create prohibitive or what were deemed as prohibitive voting
right.
laws.
Right.
As soon as the Supreme Court announced their decision, the state of Texas automatically said they are putting into effect the law that they had, which says that you have to have an ID to vote and this kind of stuff. Now, okay, you know what? In 2013, for you to have an ID, that's not a big deal. Because you can go to the
ID
anybody.
ID or a driver's license.
ID. It has to be a state-issued
ID.
ID,
yeah.
So you can go, anybody can go to the driver's license plates, pay the $15, $20, and get you an ID. You don't have to have anything for that. But let's get to the conversation is, how do you think that is going to affect? I believe there were like seven states that it directly affected immediately.
Why do people want to prohibit people from voting?
At this point?
That's my big question. Is that
it's kind of a
why is it that big of an issue to prohibit people from voting? Now, some people say they, you know, the immigrants that are coming here that don't have the right to be here are voting or whatever. I'm not buying into that. But why is there a need to put something in place to prohibit votes? This is America, land of the free, I thought. If anything, right. It would be an inclusion. You would want more people to vote.
I think from the mind of the politicians, it's way too many people they're going to be obligated to. So the less people they're obligated to, the better. I'm saying when they miss vote, there's not that many more that they have to miss vote.
What are some other things that they're able to put in there to prohibit people from voting?
Well, this is
other than putting in IDs.
I don't want to quote any years because I don't remember what year it was, but I know there was sometime early in the 2000s where they had to then revisit the ability to let
African Americans
and
vote.
Women
and
vote.
They re-upped it for I think for another 20 years or so.
Right.
That
why
still...
one? Why didn't they just abolish it?
Right.
Well, why did they re-up it?
Well, see, this is where I'm going. I'm sure somewhere in the fine print of some of those articles, I'm sure that there is something that's going to give someone a loophole. And one of those states is probably going to try to test that loophole. That's why I believe. I believe something in there gives some gray when it comes to our vote and the female, well, I guess that
you know,
both of us,
you
the
know,
female and African-American vote.
You know, I was just sitting here thinking, and I had in my mind this movie treatment. If you don't know what a treatment is, it's just it's a movie. It's like an idea for a movie. And my movie treatment was about what if the world started or whatever and African Americans or black people actually started the slavery. You know, went did everything and everything was reversed.
Oh, that's interesting.
That black people had the slaves and white people were fighting for justice and everything.
And
I have this treatment. I'm going to have to get with somebody. I might have to get with my big brother, Tommy Ford, to figure out how we can put this movie so people, and it would start off with a man who was very racist.
Really interesting.
And he's actually dying or whatever, but he wakes up and the world is completely opposite.
That's really
so white people are actually fighting for civil rights and so forth. So I have got to figure out how to do this so people
really
will understand.
I would go see that movie.
How people will really understand how that. So don't be stealing my treatment.
Right.
Okay. Don't be stealing
there,
my treatment because I have it on tape. That is mad. I'm just saying.
Okay. Yeah,
but
we have to make sure.
Because people don't understand the gravity of a lot of things that are happening or why it's happening because it's not touching them yet.
Right.
But this is actually bigger than people realize.
Absolutely.
And I don't know if Clarence Thomas actually fought for it or whatever. I have a feeling it was unanimous.
Yeah.
Which, dude, seriously. Okay, I digress.
All right. So,
but when we come
back. That's what my belief is on it. I believe that there are some loopholes that they're going to try to use. I'm sure that there's some gray, fine written information in there, some text in there that's going to give people the opportunity to try to undo some of the progress that we have made, and that's what I
think. And I think all these movies are actually just distractions for people focusing on things that are movies. I'll tell y'all about that later, because everybody's talking about aliens. We need to talk about the aliens that are right here and here. Never mind.
Aliens among us.
We're going to be back. I think I need food. I think that's what my problem is. I know I wasn't eating as good as I wanted to. I'm just saying. I'm ready to eat.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday.
Try our hickory smoked barbecue chopped chicken or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink, all for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
So the salient features, once more, of the GS4200 model. It's manufactured than its venerable predecessor, and up to, 17% quieter. Naturally, it's available in both... Sorry about that. Grain beige. I'm sorry, I think I'd better take this. It's my wife on Uvu. Hey, Pumpkin, what are you doing?
I'm Uvu-ing.
Very funny. What? 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 What?
Make the money!
Where's your mother?
Mom!
What?
I love you.
I love you too.
America Today.
All right, y'all. So, as you already know, we have talked enough about Miss Paula Deen and all of her woes. Up, down, good, bad. It is what it is. Life has not stopped. We have moved on from that. On to the Supreme Court. We discussed one of the issues. We're going to bring the other one back because I'm kind of interested in getting into that a little bit too. But I got to bring up my next guest. Now, this is a very special gentleman to me. No, it's not my fiance, y'all. Slow down. But but he's a cutie pie, nevertheless. This right here beside me is Mr. Darryl Mitchell. Now, he is an awesome, awesome spoken word artist. I have had the pleasure of working with him, of course, on What They Say They Want, the play. Also moving forward into the movie.
Yes.
And I've also had the pleasure of hearing him at his best. So welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Awesome to have him. I love him. He is such an awesome, like, cool spirit, man. You get around down. It's like you can't be hype like around him because he's just gonna cool you out. So
Yeah, keep calm. It's all on. It's all cool.
I love it. I love it. You glad to be here?
Yes, I'm very glad to be here. Thanks for having me, Shantae.
Awesome.
Feeling very well.
Tell everyone a little bit about where you're from, how you get started in spoken word.
Los Angeles, California, and I started in spoken word about 12 years ago. Now, I started out doing open mics and performing around the area, and I went from there and started writing books. And I published my first book in about 2005, and from there opened up my own publishing company. And I four published books into it, four ebooks, two albums, which I have here, Spoken Words by a Witness, Volume 1 and Volume 2, which are available on iTunes and, you know, on the website, and also other things as far as we have a radio show once a week that we want to put out spoken word and poetry and, you know, the artists and get out there. And right now, that's about it. You know, check it out. And we're into different things other than that are in the line of performing arts and artwork and retail as far as T-shirts and inspirational products and as far as empowering things that help society and help people.
Well, that actually brings me to my next question as I bust my lip. Normally playing. I didn't. But that brings me to my next question. What type of spoken word do you do?
Well, I write inspirational spoken word, inspiring spoken word, which is about everyday life and how you can overcome daily trials and also stay positive and help others and empowering things that have a message embedded.
Awesome. So it's not like I won't use that as an example. I was going to use, let's say, blank monologue. So I wasn't going to go there, but it wasn't that type of, it's not erotic poetry or anything like that?
No, not at all.
And do you use cuss words?
No, not at all.
Okay, good. Because I don't like cuss words. Use them. I might use the N-word time to time, but that's not a cuss word. It's just not a nice word. That's what I have to tell the kids.
Right.
They be like, ooh, you cuss Miss Tay. No, Miss Tay doesn't cuss.
Nah.
But I will call it in out.
Right.
I will. So right. I'm working on my deliverance is still going. I'm still a work in progress. So I'm gonna get a little personal.
Okay.
Yeah. So are you single?
Yes, I am.
Oh shucks. And you are straight?
Yes, I am.
Yeah. Yes. I'm just making sure. It's Atlanta. All right. No, I just happen to know he's a sweetheart, so I want to put that out there. Any ladies out in TV land, I'm just saying.
Right.
And he's employed, and he's got his own publishing company and all of that good stuff. So.
Thank you.
Yes. Are you on the dating scene?
I am when I do have time, but, you know, focus first, purpose first. So we handle business first, and if there's an opportunity, you know, I'm open. Yes.
Okay.
I'm going to jump in, and I'm going to help you get off the subject. You know.
We're
going to take one of the CDs at this time so we can cue something up and play it for the people. But go ahead, Tay.
Getting ready to change the subject. I was actually just going to do a cheap plug, but forget it now, Roy. I was going to say you can come out to the Single and Safe Conference on August 2nd and 3rd. But anyways, I think he's already invited. But I came out to see us out at Finding Eve a couple of weeks ago, and it was so awesome to have you out there. Everyone
great.
Loved it. Loved it. So you enjoyed?
I loved it. I enjoyed it. Awesome. Y'all can't wait to go back. That was an awesome experience.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah. We try to do what we can.
Yes.
Woo to the Finding Eve family. Anyway, now, what kind of things are you up to right now? Like what kind of thing shows upcoming and things like that?
Right now, we have the play that is up and coming, and also I'm doing audiobooks.
Nice.
So you may hear my voice on some of the popular audiobooks that are out there, narrating.
He's got that voice, doesn't he?
Right.
You should have been on. You ever heard of the Bible Experience?
No, I haven't heard of that.
You never heard of that?
No.
It's the Bible on CD.
Yes, I have.
It's the Bible on CD, but it's all like it's us doing it. Yeah, you gotta check out the Bible Experience. I have it at home, and you should have been on that.
Okay. Because
they have like what's his name? He plays Jesus, and like Kirk Franklin, and all these other people. They all have different characters in the Bible.
Oh, that sounds.
And so they all do it, and it's really cool. But anyway,
look into that.
He has a great voice. So I think he should be in like Bible Experience Part 2, like the Third Testament or something.
And play Moses or something. No, Moses.
That's the First Testament.
So Second Testament, we got to play. I'll do Paul.
I don't know who Paul is right now.
I don't know.
But you could be in the Third Testament.
Okay. All right, I'll take that. We'll wait for that one. We'll wait for that one to come out.
I'm just saying. You're right.
But
you know, it's been 2,000 some odd years since the last one. We'll just go ahead and write another one now.
Right. Let's do.
We're going to go ahead and play some of Daryl's stuff. Not stuff, but some of his work, some of his artistry. I don't want to downplay it with stuff.
I have another
one. So we're going to play one. What's the name of the one we're going to play? Okay. And one of the things that I like about his stuff is he puts it to music.
Go to the next one.
The next one.
The formula has been perfected. And the
as we wait for Roy to get his life together and the music. Yeah. Anyways. Okay, yeah. That's not it either. Come on, Roy, get your life. That is you.
That's him.
That is you.
All right, so we're going to let Daryl intro this one is what we're going to do.
All right, so tell us a little bit about it. What's the name of it?
This
what was
piece,
the inspiration?
This piece is called Call Me Love. Ooh. Now, the inspiration pretty much about the relationship between a man and a woman and dating and how he feels towards a woman and pretty much inviting her to, hey, you can give me a call. You can talk what we were talking about. If you gave me that, get to know.
Oh.
Call Me Love.
Oh, I like it. Turn it up, turn it up.
You can call me love, call me sometimes love, and tell me that you think of me. It may not mean a thing to you, but when you treat me like a king, you bring it out of me. You can call me love, I don't wanna hold you up, but see you'll benefit from this. I wanna get to know you, to sincerely serenade you, and thank God above for saving you, for me to love you like you want to be loved. You can call me love, like little delicate poetic scribblings. You can call me love, you introduce me to new ways of thinking. You can call me love, exposing my mind to things I've never before explored. It's as if I've never tasted cherries before, then after having them for the first time, I always craved it. I would steal from time just to get a second with you and risk life and eternity. You make me feel non-earthly. Can I get to know you better and show you how it feels when I hold you in my arms? I won't try to control you, nor do I mean you any harm. I like my days sunny and my conversation sweet as honey. Our communication I'm anticipating like I'm receiving money. Not to mention you canceled all uncomfortable tension that ever attempted to exist. My heart back. I see you have a knack for heart sign X, like sweet Texas. But you can call me love. You can call me love.
Okay, so three snaps up. I only got one hand, but three snaps up on that one. Okay, so keep it real. What was the inspiration for real? Who was she? What was her name? She not watching right now. What's her name?
I made her my man. Who I'm looking for, put it that way.
Ah, okay. I can dig that. So, hopefully your true missus is not watching because she'll be like, I remember you did that.
I know. Bust me out.
Right? But go ahead and give everybody your contact information.
Okay.
Everything from, you know, your Facebook, website, all that good stuff. So how, if they would like to maybe put you on to something.
Okay. You can contact me at dmitchii@yahoo.com. That's dmitchii@yahoo.com. Or you can visit my website, which is www.dmthepoet.com. You can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook under dmthepoet.com. Also, I have an online store with other supplies, V-neck, women's shirts, inspirational products. But go to the website, and that'll direct you to the publishing company and the online store and the Twitter and Facebook. So just remember dmthepoet.com. Check me out. You guys be blessed and be inspired.
Awesome. Did he almost drop the mic? I saw it was coming. He's about to sexual chocolate. I'm out. Thank you again so much for coming.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. Appreciate
love it. Love him. And like I said, he's single. Don't let him leave. Look, it's Atlanta, 20-1. He's new on the market, ladies.
So
he's
funny.
In from LA. He's fresh meat. I'm gonna mess up.
Fresh
so
fish.
He's a fresh catch. Jump in on it. We'll be back in just a few minutes. Roy's actually gonna be bringing in another guest, another very special friend of ours here. And you guys stay tuned. Stay right there.
Yes.
This is it, barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoke, barbecue chopped chicken, or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink, all for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
So the salient features, once more, of the GS4200 model. It's manufactured than its venerable predecessor, and up to, 17% quieter. Naturally, it's available in both... Sorry about that. Grain beige. I'm sorry, I think I'd better take this. It's my wife on Ubu. Hey, Pumpkin, what are you doing?
I'm Ubering.
Very funny. What?
Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Make the money!
Where's your mother?
Mom!
What?
I love you.
I love you too.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoke, barbecue chopped chicken, or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink, all for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
Do you need business cards, CD inserts, flyers, posters, or rack cards to promote your business or event? Well, if so, there's only one place to go. All Graphics and Printing. Check them out on the web at allgraphicsandprinting.com or give them a call at 407-532-4777. All Graphics and Printing, shipping all across the country and the official flyer and business card provider for the Jericho Broadcast Network.
Today.
Right. Welcome to Urban America Today. Again, we are broadcasting live from Little Ozio's at the corner of 749 Moreland Avenue. Yeah, 749. I just had a brain fart. That's what I did. I am sitting here with the gentleman that saved the day. This is the ex I was talking about, my, my,
frat brother. Phi Beta Sigma in the building. Spring 90?
Spring 90.
Spring 90?
Yes, sir.
Number three?
Number four.
Number four, my bad. Number four, number four.
Number four.
Yep. What was the name of the line again?
Blue Armageddon. Armageddon.
There you go. Uh-huh. Shout out your line brothers. We got to shout out your line brothers, man.
Shout out to Rob Colton, Dexter Mitchell, Matt Bowman, and Willie Poncho Bona, and yours truly right here, number four, Leon Rogers. Hi, America.
Man, you know what? I'm going to tell y'all something. I'm going to holler at one of our frat brothers. That Lunch Meat was like the best. I mean, that was his lie day. Lunch Meat was the best flag football quarterback in history.
Lunch Meat, that's my dude right there. Nothing but love for Lunch Meat right there.
There it is.
Yes, sir.
All right, so I told you guys we were going to be bringing Leon in. We're going to be talking about some of the new programs and things that we've got that are going to be coming onto the network here in the next few months. And actually, Leon's going to be involved in a couple of things that we're working on. Let's start off with the music one. We won't talk about who all you're talking about meeting, but just kind of what you're looking to do with the whole hip-hop thing.
Well, I had an idea for a show. Well, backstory, I'm a bit of a music nerd. Started a long time ago with hip-hop. My cousin back in Brooklyn, at the age of 12, he had equipment. I know you kids today don't know what equipment is, but he had the two turntables, the Gemini mixer. He had all the great breakbeat records back in the day. And I used to just go up to his place and just listen to those records, and I just got really into them. And especially with hip hop and all the sampling that's done, you know, today's songs are cool, but what's even more fascinating is the records that that started those records out there, those right. original samples. And so I had an idea of doing a show where we would talk about, you know, some of the artists today, do like a critique or an in-depth discussion of some of the artists and some of their music, perhaps play some of those important hip hop records we hear today, and maybe hear those samples where they came from.
Oh man, and that's gonna be great because you know, y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all, man, y'all young folks today, y'all really don't know what hip hop is. This is, I hate to say it, you know, there's still some underground hip hop that's real hip hop, as we like to say, but today's music industry to me is just really watered down. I mean. Yeah. You talk about a situation where, as I like to say it, every 3 years they come out with the same set of new artists, meaning that they're just like the other guys that came out 3 years before them, but their shelf life is over now. So, you know, they're doing some stuff, but that's going to be a great show. I know we're working on a couple of people. We got to get Daddy O involved in that one.
Yes, sir.
You know, we talked to him about that. We're going to be looking at bringing some other folks in and get some folks involved in that. So that'll definitely be some old school hip hop stuff we got coming up. But now. No, I was really, really intrigued by this next one. Y'all know that I'm into politics. And like, he's a music nerd. You know, I'm a politics nerd. I do consulting and this stuff. And he was telling me about a show idea that he and his lovely fiance, who didn't want to come on camera, is Malika, who didn't want to come on camera. She's still not hearing me, so I'm gonna leave it alone. But yeah. And so, you know, they're gonna do this talk show that is gonna be really. And I'm going to let you use my microphone because I think I know what it is.
Okay.
Yeah, this one's working. My voice, that's just right. Louder.
Live TV. Got to love it. Anyway, so my fiance, Malika, and I, on Sunday mornings, you know, we usually have breakfast and we watch the Sunday morning political talk shows. And we end up discussing a lot of the topics that they cover. And we figured between the two of us, we have at least one decent brain, and that would, of course, be my fiance. So we came up with this idea of doing a show called Kitchen Cabinet, where we get to discuss the issues of the day or of the week and over some really great food and have really great conversation with some people who are involved in politics, some of the people who are involved in those discussions, so that we can have, I guess, a larger idea of what things are going on in spite of what you hear on the nightly news. Because we have to remember one thing about the news nowadays, especially in the 24-hour news cycle era. It's no longer so much about the news. It's more about entertainment. It's about how many eyeballs you can get on a particular program. So they'll have the most outrageous things on there just to make sure that your eyes keep tuned and glued on and see what's going on. There's really not too much difference between, I know everybody likes to talk about Fox News and MSNBC and CNN and how one is so right-wing and the other one is left-wing and liberal and all this other stuff, but they're basically just essentially trying to cater to an audience. It's no longer about what's happening actually on the news. It's about trying to figure out, okay, well, this is what this group of people like, so we're going to promote these stories in that way so that we can keep this certain demographic watching. So we want to just get back essentially to what's news and have those big discussions and big ideas.
Well, and that's going to be good. And of course, that'll be coming from a you know, call it what you want, to a black perspective, African-American perspective. Because, yes, we do talk politics. We do sit around and do that. Come on now. You know, we're involved. We definitely are engaged in the whole process.
That's right. Don't let the glasses fool. Yeah, I'm kind of smart. Something
there
like
it
that.
Is. Uh-huh. We say something. So, you know, I mean, what else you got going on now? Let's talk about, you know, we haven't had you on before, so let's do this. Leon is also a member of the cast of What They Say They Want, and he plays the character Don, and getting ready for it. So this is not his first foray, though, into the realm of acting and doing his thing. So we're going to let Leon talk a little bit about some of the stuff he's been involved in before.
Well, mostly I've been involved in New York City with Black Spectrum Theater Company, which was founded by Carl Clay back in the early 70s in the Queens, New York area. And I've been doing I was doing shows with them for a number of years. Some of the more notable shows we did The Piano Lesson. Let's see, I'm trying to remember, I'm drawing blanks here. Let's see, Five Guys Named Mo, Ain't Misbehaving. One of the more important pieces that we did there was we did a play about Amos and Andy called Kingfish, Amos and Andy, where we kind of explored that era and that television show and just some of the things that were going on in that particular show. I loved it personally because it taught me a whole lot about what was going on and how basically acting is the job that people want to do. This is what actors do. They want to work. I know a lot of people got into the controversy of what Amos and Andy was all about, but it's really more important that you end up, you know, studying that and see what happened and talk about the actors and everybody was involved there. Now, cutting to the quick, I'm going to also talk about What They Say They Want. Of course, my good friend here, Roy, he wrote the movie, and I'll be playing the character of Don. Don is a fella who is of a certain age and only likes women, usually about 25 and younger. He's this guy who never really grew up, you know, into video games and playing them all day. And he really doesn't want the stress of this whole life of women telling him what to do, where to sit, how to eat, where to be at, where to go. You know, he wants to be carefree. So he likes that excitement of being with younger women.
Yeah, and then we pair him up with Rachel, who's like the other way. And as he said, live TV, y'all, this is why we got to get us another producer. Yeah, I had to, y'all saw me looking over like this here, like that's on Shantae. We gonna put that one on her today too. So, but yep, blasting out again, holla, cause we do that.
I'm in your corner. You are not alone. No Michael Jackson. All right, anyway, go.
But no, yeah. So we're definitely looking forward to it. Leon was a great help as we were getting to play together and stuff. And yes,
I called him.
And then I called Malika's name twice.
That's right.
Saying stuff. But somebody was over there talking to Malika, so she didn't hear me. Hello. Right. Blah, 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 blah.
Moving
blah, blah,
right
blah, blah, blah.
Moving right along.
So, right. We're gonna get ready. We're going to let her go ahead. Wow.
We're glad and she wow spelled backwards is wow. Let that blow your mind.
We're going to let her push play on the break so that we can get ready to go to the break. Okay. So,
all right.
Okay, there's the music. Yeah. Well, we want to thank Leon for coming out and definitely
thank
be
you.
Looking forward to seeing him in What They Say They Want. Looking for him and Miss Malika in Kitchen Cabinet and doing that things. And so we'll definitely be getting some folks in and talking about that. We're going to come back with me and Tay and Tara, and we're going to talk some more stuff. We got a few more things to talk about. Because it's something that y'all know I ain't said yet, but we got to get going. So we'll be back with more Urban America Today, y'all, right after this horror.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoked barbecue chopped chicken or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink. All for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
So the salient features, once more, of the GS4200 model. It's manufactured than its venerable predecessor, and up to, 17% quieter. Naturally, it's available in both, grain beige. I'm sorry, I think I'd better take this. It's my wife on Uvu. Hey, Pumpkin, what are you doing?
I'm Ubering.
Very funny. What?
Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Dad.
What?
Make the money!
Where's your mother?
Mom!
What?
I love you.
I love you too.
Barbecue and seafood. Have lunch with us Monday through Friday. Try our hickory smoked barbecue chopped chicken or our two-piece fried whiting with one signature side, bread, and a free drink. All for just $5.99. Visit any one of our locations all over Atlanta or order online at thisisitbbq.com.
Do you need business cards, CD inserts, flyers, posters, or rack cards to promote your business or event? Well, if so, there's only one place to go. All Graphics and Printing. Check them out on the web at allgraphicsandprinting.com or give them a call at 407-532-4777. All Graphics and Printing. Shipping all across the country. And the official flyer and business card provider for the Jericho Broadcast Network.
to Urban America Today.
I don't know who they calling a control freak.
You.
I am not a control freak.
Hi,
I don't know
my
what
name
y'all
is Roy.
About.
I'm a control freak. Say it with me.
Hi, my name is Roy. I'm a control freak.
So?
Your turn.
I'm not going to say it.
Yeah, we said it for you.
Right.
Okay, well, we're back. Welcome back. Hey, everybody.
Urban.
We had some really awesome guests today.
We did.
We did. We did. Yes. Had some good people.
We did, and I was able to eat my food.
Yeah.
That
yep.
was really good.
I am very ashamed of these two eating as they were talking to you guys.
We were whatever. Just very unprofessional. We were just showing you how good the food really was.
At Ozio's, exactly.
At
that was the whole purpose.
Little Ozio's is the bomb.
I don't have any makeup on at everything. You know the food is good when you don't have any more makeup on.
Yep. Hey, wait a minute. Y'all know
wait
what?
Wait a minute. Why'd you use
I forgot
your face
something.
To eat? What?
I forgot something.
What?
We forgot to talk about something.
Oh.
Miami Heat world champions, baby.
Okay, so holla
at your
news,
boys.
Supreme Court has... We're done.
Had to do it.
Come on.
Had to
come
do
on.
It.
Quick.
All right, quick.
So
yeah.
The Supreme Court had made another ruling, right, on the same-sex marriage thing.
Right.
We quickly transitioned from that mess. So,
haters.
Whatever. So, as I said, they made another ruling on that. Mm-hmm. So now everything is back to as it was with the state of California and several other states to where they've overturned the overturning. And same-sex marriage is now back to the state level, and it's now legal again in those places where it was before.
Well, actually, the other part of that, if I'm not mistaken, the biggest part of it is that they have said that those folks who have the same-sex marriages can actually now receive
federal benefits.
Well, so they can use their job benefits. That's what the
good job.
That's what the big deal
right,
about it was,
right,
and
the
then
federal,
it turned mm-hmm. it over back to the states.
So,
the
like, if me and her were together, I could get her pension when she
right.
When
you know, you could be
retires.
On the same Medicaid
yeah.
or medical insurance and all that kind of stuff.
Hey, dude,
so.
I don't right. judge. Do you? I have no heaven or hell to put you in. So you do you, and love each other. Do whatever.
I always love to refer back to that comedian. I don't know if you guys ever saw it, but there was a comedian who was talking about same-sex marriages, and he was freaking hilarious. He was like, I think it was Martin, actually. And he was like,
Martin
he was
Lawrence?
Like, I'm trying to remember who it was. It was a black male, all I remember. But he
that
was saying,
nails it down.
Right, a whole lot. BET, right. So what I'm saying is he said that straight people are having marital problems enough, and the divorce rate is so darn high as it is, and half the people that are married are not happily married as it is. He's like, if they want to join the miserable gang with the rest of them, I say go ahead and let them.
Oh, wow.
He said if they want to give it a shot, I think they can do better at it, go for it.
The sad part is majority of divorces, well, that's because majority of marriages are
straight.
Heterosexual,
but,
yeah.
Heterosexual.
But we'll see
things.
What those statistics look like in about 10 more years. But anyway. Yep. We need to go back to this.
Oh yeah, Paula
Deen.
Thing. Right, right.
Why
we gotta,
are we? Okay,
we,
so
no,
this
we've
is what
we gotta clarify some of the stuff.
This is
because,
what had
right.
happened. Okay, so we were advised that, or I was educated. And again, I'm a trust but verify because that's what I do. So
right.
I'm gonna do some research tonight.
Yes.
But I was advised that the situation is not just what she said 30 years ago or whatever. She recently was trying to plan a wedding.
Correct.
So the reception would be a plantation reception where they would have waiters that are African-American in white suits and ties,
well,
you know, with the white.
Here, let's change it a minute. She wanted a plantation wedding from slavery times is basically what it boiled
right,
down
that's
to.
That's what it boiled down to.
Yeah,
and
this was
I bet she was a white guy. But anyway, but this was rather recent.
It'd be funny if it was a black person. Just saying.
But, you know, if. They probably would have done it because she was going to pay that much. But the fact that she wanted that, she requested that.
Right. That's I remember reading that. That's what I heard. And I mm-hmm. thought somewhere in that is where she said the word, the N word. Mm-hmm. And that's why I thought that when you said that it was connected. But yeah, that was my understanding that she wanted to do this plantation themed wedding from slavery period and have those
yeah.
folks dressed like that and kind of stuff. So. You know what?
But my thing was she's being crucified not for that. She's being all this big hoopla and people pulling their shows and their plugs and everything and their association with her is because of the N-word, not because she wants that type
well,
of wedding.
Well, I think that's part of it, but I think it's
well,
a whole
right.
gamut of stuff.
That's
but
just
what
a lightning
her
rod.
Racist,
but
what
right.
what I'm,
right.
what
that's
I'm,
just a lightning
so
rod.
It's not just because of the N-word that she said to call her racist. There are certain things that she did, like the wedding. Like when she said certain things that she portrayed herself to be a racist by saying certain things. Whether she is or not, I don't know. But she put herself in a position, from what they're saying, to become a racist. And she may just be one. I don't know. I don't really...
Well, she don't pay my bills. Other race. I told her how to make the fried chicken because I heard it's real good. She don't pay my bills.
So, but what I'm going to do, I have to do some research on this whole thing because, you know,
I'm going to need to research in someone the food.
Here. What was your
I
name
need
again,
a free
honey?
Plate, Paula.
Tabitha. That's I'm Tabitha.
Can I quote you, Tabitha? Tabitha brought a very good point. Is that we're crying over Paula losing her job. There's black folk that are losing their job for no reason whatsoever. And so there are some other things that are affecting the African-American culture right now other than Paula Deen. So all I can say is don't get all hemmed up with the distraction. There are certain things that are going on
but
right
you know
now.
What?
I totally concur.
Lady, here,
and there are plenty of black people who lost their jobs just because they were black.
Well, but here's the deal, and this is the thing, and, you know, this is my whole point with it, where I feel like it's being blown out of proportion, because I do. I think the same thing. It's really being used as a distraction to take us away from the other things. And again, Paula Deen is getting more press than what has happened with the Voting Rights Act.
Yes. If anything, I hope she doesn't get sick over the stress. But at the end of the day, she's probably going to make more money off of all this hoopla.
Oh, I mean,
what's her name? Did it? Like cleaning lady.
Like Leon said, Martha Stewart. Somebody is going to give her.
Lady.
Somebody's going to get her back on the air.
Oh, she will not be off the air. She'll probably
bounce back
and have her own daggone
just like
network.
Hello,
and her
on the own network.
She'll probably end up be on the own network.
Right, exactly.
Don't play.
So
I'm just gonna say I understand
because she was on OWN network
you
before
told
with Oprah.
Paula to
so
beat me.
No, the OWN would be like, oh, you know what? Oprah be like, girl, don't even sweat it. After this dies down, I got you. I bet you. Watch she come up on the OWN, and when she comes up on the OWN, y'all gonna have to say I'm right. Ooh, Madam Money was right.
There it is, tied to die.
I'm not gonna dispute
because
it.
At the end of the day, Oprah
you
needs
told
white
Paula work. To beat me.
You know what? Boom.
Yes, both of us had to do that because she done went there twice at this point.
I'm LOLing. After you played The Color Purple, then you turn around and you put Paula Deen on your network.
Hey, guess what we haven't done yet?
What?
The views and opinions expressed by the hosts and the guests of this show are not necessarily those of the Jericho
Why
Broadcast Network, Sky City
Why
Media Group, Little Ozzy-O's, or anybody else affiliated other than her.
Why
so.
Did I do? They always do this to me,
it
y'all.
Wasn't my fault this time.
I'm not responsible for the things that come out of my mouth.
Yeah, we see that.
I didn't do it.
She is not responsible for the things that come out of her mouth. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, Paula Deen's not responsible for what comes out of hers.
Obviously she is. And I'm going to watch the Today Show tomorrow. Is it coming on tomorrow or did it come on today?
She
was
held at gunpoint. What
was
she supposed to do?
I'm still not buying that.
But no, she was on with Matt Lauer this morning.
She was on with Matt Lauer. What was she supposed
somebody
to do?
Needs to tell, somebody needs to give me the YouTube clip of Matt Lauer's interview with her. Cause that
freaking me.
Okay.
Who saw to today's show?
Usa
I need to see that.
Usa.
Matt right. Lauer.
So
Matt Lauer is pissed.
But you know what?
Matt Lauer.
We're playing
pissed.
Into the game too because we keep talking about Paula. So I'm over it. Done.
Right. I was about to say. Let's stop.
Oh, can I just say this though? Wait. This ain't about Paula really. It's about Matt Lauer. The day I was watching TV, which is extremely rare, I was watching TV the day that she was supposed to come on to the Good Morning America show or whatever it is, and she canceled.
Yeah, Matt was
Matt
mad.
Lauer had a freaking bane the size
pissed.
Of my finger coming out of his head.
Matt was like, well,
was
she was a no-show.
Livid.
He was mad because he didn't have nothing to talk about.
Oh, okay.
So mad, yeah. And then what's the black guy, y'all? The black guy, big black guy on Good Morning America.
He ain't big no more.
Well, he's not as big as he used to be, but he's still thick. He's still
he's
cuddly little bear.
I can't
yes,
even
he
think
is.
About it. You got me. You
anyway, so
like
y'all know what I'm talking about when y'all watch
he
the show.
He does look like a little bear.
I'm thinking, Willard, was she afraid to come on because he might have questioned her?
Okay, right. Yeah. Okay, let's stop. No, he's the weather guy. No, they weren't.
I
they
know
weren't.
He's the
they
guy.
Weren't going to put him up for that one.
He's just
okay,
the weather guy.
So no, let's go back to
that's
the. No, I'm not saying it that way. They weren't going to put him in that sit. They would have brought Lester Holt in before they let him do the interview.
No, he was there. So.
He was there, but he was there, but he wasn't
going
to do the interview.
He wasn't going to do
the interview. No,
yeah.
Matt Lauer was doing the interview.
So okay,
fact,
Matt
she came
Lauer
to the city.
Gonna...
She came into New York and she was in the hotel. She just
they
didn't
flew
come to
her
the show.
To New York and then she didn't come
yeah,
out.
The show flew
she
her
was
in.
Sick. She was crying all night long.
Yeah,
she
they
was,
said that
you
she
know,
was exhausted. That's
she
what
probably
they
was. I believe her.
Well, apparently it wasn't
Matt
that big
was like,
of a deal.
If this hoe don't get in,
because they rescheduled her for today. So
it was a big deal.
It is what it is.
Oh, because it was on CNN. It was a really big deal.
All right. So yeah, we're all over Paula. Hold up.
Yeah.
Y'all don't be trying to brush over my story.
Let's back
nobody
up.
Cares.
Let's back
nobody
up.
Nobody really cares.
Let's back up.
Nobody
cares.
Sports and entertainment's not here today.
I'm here, so that doesn't matter.
Nobody really.
That's
does
the only
someone
one
want to hear
talk.
The Madam Money moment?
We
talk, yes.
We talked about.
To me about
we talked about
money.
The entertainment. Where
talk to me
did
about
nobody
money.
Else go to but you?
Hey, I was. That was a filler.
Uh-huh.
He left me here by myself. What else was I going to talk about? So
oh,
I was at Nene's wedding.
All I want y'all to do.
It was fabulous.
All I want y'all to do is to give my boys some props, please.
Nene Leakes.
Just
I've heard the
from
name.
The Housewives.
Just,
yes.
Just
yes.
Look, just give my boys some props. Say congratulations to the Miami Heat. Okay, come on now, y'all. As much dragging y'all you do. So
and I can't wait for football. So when football wow. comes,
yay.
Then we can talk.
So how about
are you
those
ready
Atlanta
for some
Braves?
Football?
Wow, really though, y'all. Okay,
go
okay.
Braves.
Nobody really cares about the Heat.
Uh huh.
So
let me ask you. Let me ask you guys this question
go
though. Let's
Braves.
let's
that
get into
baseball,
this
right?
though. Something
yeah.
else.
Oh, okay.
You're just changing
something. So so what are we?
And
what are we thinking?
Talking.
Yes, because I'm talking about something different now.
Oh, okay. What's up?
Blah 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 blah.
Matt Lauer, y'all see? You see?
That's called the Matt Lowry now. You get that vein coming out of your head? That's gonna be called the Matt Lowry.
No, so let's. I mean, let's talk about it. I mean, this is the first one we've done it at this time because we were actually considering changing the show to this time.
Okay.
So what do y'all think? I mean, might do some other stuff.
You're assuming,
Tara made a good
you're
point.
You're assuming that I don't have anything to do on a Wednesday night.
What if someone decides
to ask me out on a
I'm
date?
I'm not assuming.
Hint, hint. Single heterosexual males.
Does it matter of race, height, anything else matter?
Job.
Employed.
Self-sufficient.
Okay.
Own transportation.
Has a vehicle.
Good credit.
Okay.
Savings.
Okay.
Looking to take care of a woman.
Uh-oh.
Not necessarily financially, you know.
That's where you went.
You know
lost
what I'm saying?
Them. Oh, no.
Every
no.
man that was
oh,
like,
oh,
okay.
I'm sorry. They want to be
out.
The king of the household, but they don't want the responsibility
See, no,
of being
no.
the king.
No, but they're not coming in. No, they're not coming in looking for a woman who's looking to be taken care of.
I don't have to be
no,
taken care
see,
of. I've been taking
just,
care of myself for
okay,
40
hold
damn
hold
years.
Just breathe,
so that
breathe,
we're clear.
Breathe,
okay?
Both of y'all.
I want a man that is open or wants to take care of his woman, okay? You ain't got to take care of me. I took care of myself for 40 damn years.
Tara,
I'm
Tara,
just saying.
Tara, can we go back to the question, Tara and Shay, or Tay, about the date
she
time
started
of the,
it.
I know. It's her fault
just
again.
Just because you engaged, don't be like shutting me down, all
no,
right?
No. I want,
okay.
you to, have a man all day long. What I'm saying is you don't want to do it with your eyes open, talk about, somebody come take care of me. That's what I was thinking.
Didn't I just say I've been taking care
did.
Of my
you did.
Damn
you
self
did.
Of 40 years?
Yes, and you tired of doing it. And she tired of doing
you know
it.
You know what I'm saying? I did good. I'm tired.
So
I'm just throwing
just
it out there.
That. I just
you know,
said
I,
that.
And
so,
you tired
of
doing it.
So, yeah, let's, again, thank you. We're rolling
we
back
keep,
in.
We
are you looking for a woman to take care of?
We're rolling back in.
Are you looking for a woman to take
Tay,
care of?
Tay, turn around and look at the camera.
No, they want to be kings, but they don't want responsibility.
Oh, look, hold up.
Amen.
Slow your roll, baby
Amen.
Girl. We done had this discussion before because it ain't nothing wrong with the equipment here in any era. So I know how to handle my household. Let's get it writ. R-I-G-H-T. Let's get it rich.
All right. Well, we All were right. talking about having
the
show
in the evenings. I say we move it to Thursday nights. Starting
was,
at 9:30.
Started that whole
oh, no. Okay. Oh, no.
What?
Oh, no. Let me tell you why that's
Who's
not
happening?
Gonna work.
What?
Thursday nights at 9:30.
Oh.
Let me tell you why that's not
going to
work. Because as soon as scandal starts back up, oh. there is
I
no way.
I did that
way.
On purpose, too.
No way.
She fed right
I will
into
not be
it.
Here. Y'all will have fun. It's been real.
Actually, we probably won't have an audience, though.
It's
going to be me and you.
Scandal watch parties.
That's
you know,
what
we should
do
that.
What do
know,
they call them? What is it again?
Scandaholics.
No, yeah.
The tailgates.
Yeah. We'll have to do tailgating for scandal.
I am a scandalista.
That's how we'll get an audience.
I am
scandalista.
So tailgating.
I am a scandalista.
That's a new one. I hadn't heard of scandalista
Because
before.
I am the only one.
Oh.
Get it right.
It's a new club. You should get a Facebook
right.
page. Scandalistas.
I am a scandalista.
All right. So
scandalista.
Okay.
All right. So we're going to eventually be back. We're like I said, we've got a whole lot of new stuff coming on with the network.
So
we're getting things together.
We have new faces.
Well, we don't know yet. Yeah,
we have new
that's
faces.
The thing. We're going to have new faces.
Well, why don't you all tell us what you think?
Alone?
Like Wednesday evenings or in, you know, during
yeah.
the day?
Poll.
Which do you like? Poll sounds
Facebook
like a poll,
poll.
To me.
Yeah, we'll add that. We'll load that up on the page.
Oh, you already responded. Can I Facebook poll them my poll from the other day?
It's gotten a whole lot of you didn't respond. So I put up an FB poll.
I didn't see it
the other day. I know. So now you got to go do it. All right. So I'm gonna poll you guys that are listening and everybody that's in the room that is a friend of mine. So you responded. So if you are an unemployed person,
okay,
you are driving down the road.
Okay.
You don't remember. This is terrible. You're driving down the road, okay, and you come upon a unsuspecting random bag on side of the road. But your curiosity is piqued.
You're walking because driving, you ain't going to see it. But you said walking.
No, this person was... This was actually a true story, by the way.
Oh, okay. I didn't
No,
know
you're
that.
Driving down the street, and you happen to see... It could be like a one lane, two lane, or whatever. So you see this random bag, very unsuspecting. Looks like it's a lost bag, and you decide... that bag looks kind of curious. Let me
do
go check it out.
Do black people really do that?
I'm going to stop you in a second. Listen to the car.
All right, go on, finish.
So, you stop, you check out this bag. When you open up the bag, you open up the bag to find two huge wads of $100 bills, totaling to something of the fact of $20,000. You are unemployed. Okay, $20,000. But they are wrapped in bank wrap. Do you A, return them back to the bank from which you assume they came by the bank wraps, or B, do you keep it moving?
Well, coming from a financial institution person, if it's coming in a bank wrap, more than likely it's not going to have the name of the bank on the bank wrap. So I'm curious as to, you know, how am I going to know what bank to take it to? Well, no, anyway.
I just told you it has the bank wrap.
It has the bank name on it.
It does have the bank name on it.
Yeah, she changed it slightly, but yes, it has the bank name on it. What do you
do? I didn't change it slightly. That's what I put up.
That is a morally, that's an ethical dilemma.
You know what? I don't think so. Let me. This was my thing.
Okay, we got one. Keep it moving.
That's an ethical dilemma.
This was my answer to it. What I said is that if it had the name of the bank on it, that I would return the money. Because at the end of the day, I know where that comes from, and that's stealing. So I'm not going to do that.
Well, that's
now,
karma.
What I did turn around and say, had that joker been wrapped in some rubber bands, guess what?
It was good as gone.
Okay, so I'm going to have to go with Brumman. If I didn't know where the money came from and it's not identified where it was and it's just whatever, dude, I got a couple bills I need to pay off, okay?
Right.
If there's no identification in
so
there and I don't know what
it
is.
So you're not turning it into police either?
I ain't turning
it
into
nobody.
Mark? Nobody.
Okay. Between
but
us?
If it has the bank wrapped between and the bank us? Name is on it, which
but if it has the bank name on it, ethically,
now the bag is
no.
Just
if it has a bank name on the money,
wraps.
Ethically, I would take it back. Hopefully, they'll give me something or
yeah,
whatever.
Not going to. Right,
but
banks are not going to give you anything.
They may.
No, they're not.
You're
I'm
right.
Telling you this by fact.
No, you're right. They won't. But we'll
say thank you.
They'll thank you. They'll thank you. And yeah,
if it's your bank, they may waive a fee.
And so
I want to ask other people that are here.
But I'm curious though. Even though it had the bank wraps on it, it could have been someone else's cash that fell off. So it may not necessarily be
the banks
anymore.
Which is why I said that's why I would take it back. Now, here's the other thing I said to it with it as well, because somebody made a point after I said that, you know, if it was just wrapped up in something, I said, listen, here's the reality of
There's
it.
There's a lot of responses to that
if
post.
That,
so.
Yeah, if it was legit, if that money was legit, and say it was Tara's great grandma money for her surgery. Well, what's gonna happen is Tara gonna get on the news and be like, "We lost a whole bunch of money."
This is what he said.
If it's legit, then I'm gonna hold on to it until I see somebody come out and claim and say, "Okay, well, then, you know what? Then I'm gonna get that money back, even if it had the rubber bands on it." But let me tell y'all something. I'm from Miami, South Florida. We done seen bags of money sitting on the side of the street that done fell off of somebody's truck. I'm going to spread that money out over some nondescript accounts.
Well, let me just,
and I'm
gonna
roll
let me just
on.
Throw this out here. This is just legalities. Anything that's over $10,000 and 1 cent or $10,000,
right.
It has to be reported to the Fed.
Right.
So it's going to be reported that you made a significantly large. If there's anything over $3,000 or if
right.
it's in $3,000, and that's within the same financial institution. So don't go to a Wells Fargo. Wait
sweetie.
A minute. Let me finish.
Okay.
Don't try to do $2,000 at this branch of Wells Fargo and $2,000 at this branch of Wells
right.
Fargo. They're all intertwined because they're going to see your total deposits
yes.
of $10,000 and they're going to do
reporting. They're gonna do the form.
And I just left that place, but it's a currency, a CTR.
Okay.
It's a currency transaction report, something like that. Mm-hmm. But it's a CTR that they have to report. Right. Now, if it's 3,000 or more in different transactions, they're going to report that too.
See, you missed what I said, right? See, when I say
overseas.
No. I didn't say overseas. No, I said nondescript accounts. Do you understand what that means? I'm going to go get me a Walmart prepaid card. I'm going to go get me a Rush card. I'm going to go get me an Ace Green Dot card.
Okay, so.
Holla at your boy.
What is that disclosure again that you say?
Right. Things that we would do.
Yeah.
So
but no, because
I come from the financial services industry and might want to work back there again.
That
so
won't work.
I don't condone what.
Jail is real.
I don't want
to.
I don't
see,
condone
no,
that's not jail
anything
because
that
nobody
he said and everything that came out of his mouth are not of the views or opinions of that of Tara Jackson Enterprises, Tara Jackson. The person, the
okay,
future
look,
employee, Madam Money, Prosperity Now
Hold
Incorporated,
on.
Or
okay,
anything
so let me
that
go
she's
ahead.
Affiliated with. I'm just saying.
So silly. As I said, I pulled this on Facebook. What I did not tell you guys was this was actually a true story.
I'm sure it was.
I posted it, reposted
sure
it without names.
Before.
No. This happened this week to a teacher in Michigan. A teacher in Michigan who this happened to her. She did take the money back to the bank. All they said was, thank you very much, because the bank is not going to reward her with anything.
She can't.
And the lady had told her that the manager took the bag from her and thanked her for doing it. And the lady said, you are a really, she said, you've got
to
be the most honest person in the world. The lady looked back to her and said, or the stupidest. And they closed the door.
Wow. So, well, you know, hey, like y'all said, the banks aren't going to do that because that's what they're about is making money. It's all a racket. So, you know.
Yeah.
Well,
it's not that it's a
but
racket.
But at least if
again,
you go to the police, they'll give you a reward. You take it back to the bank, you ain't getting jacked, but I thank you
we
very much and have a great day.
We can't give you a reward. That's not.
No,
I know that.
I know
some of my church friends would have been like, look, I'm going to tithe on that money and keep it rolling.
Okay. Oh, I had a whole bunch.
Again,
I had a whole bunch of my church friends on there. That was
right.
Like, I just can't do it. A lot of people said, I can't do it. I had people like Roy, a few people that say, you know where I'm from, and most of them were from New York. They were like, you know what it is. And I was like, yes,
I'm just
I
saying,
do.
I'm from up north. Y'all know what it is. But as long as I'm on TV and I'm talking about the situation ethically, I would have to give it back to the financial institution without expecting any
as
type
long
of
as
reward.
I'm on TV. That's
because I'm sure
answer.
That they're aware of those serial numbers that is missing, and they're going to be looking for that information.
Yeah,
so,
right.
That is true.
Exactly.
See, that's the stuff you run into.
I am clear. Yeah. I'm clear about that. Now, when the cameras go off and we're talking offline,
we'll
have this discussion
different.
In another manner.
It might be a little different.
Hilarious.
But so yeah,
I had a few people that said they had to pray about it. It was a lot actually. A few that said they had to pray over it.
Yeah.
So I asked one friend of mine in South Carolina. I said, so let me ask you a question. Why are you waiting on the answer from God? Are you going to stop by Nordstrom? She said, oh yes, ma'am. I said, see what I'm saying? Is she a pastor's wife?
That's funny.
She a pastor's wife. She said, I'm going to stop by Nordstrom's while I'm waiting
for
the answer.
And then you can always look at it this way. God gives blessings in the most unique, special
well,
ways.
Well, that's what somebody
See,
else said.
What
somebody said, I'm going to count my blessings at home.
All $20,000.
My other point. You remember my other point? As I know, as I took it to scripture and to say the wealth of the wicked is laid up. And I said, no, this is how I said it. I said the wealth of the wicked is laid up, on the side of the road in a bag.
Right.
For the righteous Roy. End quote.
Hilarious.
I was like, whoo!
All them sanctimonious
you
people.
Oh, no, I'm for real.
Roy.
I'm for real. I'm like, hey, look here. But
all
you know what?
So anyway.
And here's the funny thing. I actually had that happen to me when I was a child.
You were a child.
I did.
You didn't have the consciousness to think straight.
No, I was like 12 or 13 when it happened.
So We turned the money in.
No. It was a different situation. It was money in a bag, and you know, like I said I'm 12, 13 years old, and it had to be almost $2,000 in the bag. Mm-hmm. But we were out at an event. We were at like a football game or something, and you know, kids, we used to be all up under the bleachers and stuff, and so we the bag was down there. We actually found the bag.
I'm keeping it. Baby what girl. Was you doing? Who was
you
under
know,
there with you?
We look, all used to be under them bleachers. Why are you lying?
Okay, for real.
Oh, I have a story to tell.
Okay, okay,
finish.
I'm not done.
No, he's not done. Finish. What I say? I have a story to tell. Go ahead and finish. That's what I say.
So what we were, what we did is, we started to because like a couple of my friends was just like, no, man, we gonna keep this money. I'm like, no, no, we're not gonna keep this money. We took the money to the booth at the place. And, you know, we ended up making an announcement. We debated on it for a little bit because they were trying to fight me for this money. So it ended up being like maybe 2 or 3 hours after we found it. But we took it back, and they made an announcement over the PA system that there was a sum of money that was found under the bleachers. If you've lost any money, please, you know, come back or, you know, come to the bleachers. That actually, well, nobody knows how much it was, so it's like people would have been taking random guesses. It wasn't like it was, and it was a specific amount of money. And what had happened was the lady that had lost it had left and didn't know, but some relative of hers had come back out to the field. So they called her and they went and got her and they came back out to the thing. She described how much money, how the bills were broken down and stuff. And she actually ended up giving, I think she gave me like $100. For turning it back into her. But, you know, I mean, and I'm looking at it because like, it was in a bag. And I know how my grandma was. My grandma used to put money in a bag, and, you know, when she got bills and stuff to pay. So it was just like.
My grandma said put it in her granny bag. Okay, y'all know what a granny bag is?
Here is where my ethical stance is, okay? Because if someone lost cash like that, I would probably turn it in, hoping that someone would find it. The reason why is I firmly believe in karma. If I had lost a sum of money, I would be praying to God that the Lord will touch them enough to be honest enough to turn it in if it's a substantial amount of money. I would probably have to chalk it up as a loss, but you never know. There are some good people in the world that are honest people, and I would pray that that would happen. So my thing is I would probably turn it in a certain situation because I would want someone to do the same thing for me.
Understood.
However,
here we go.
If there ain't no identification up in there, and I can't find you, or I don't know where to put you, or whatever.
I can see her like this on the side of the road with the unmarked bills and no wraps. Hello?
Did anybody lose any money?
Does this belong to
anybody?
Hello? Okay, I can definitely see
I
that.
Would try to find you.
And she do that for 5 minutes, and then she get in her car, and she's speeding off.
We're going to let Tay tell her story before we leave.
I would wait. Maybe they would turn around. You know, I wait a good 10, 15 minutes.
She lying. Turn around. 5 max. She out. Okay, so this is something. This is like, for me, this has been the story of the week. I want, like, everybody's attention. All right, so I'm making sure. No, you don't want to do that. How old are your children?
Story.
I want to know how old.
13, 16, 24, right.
Okay.
No, you got they got teenagers. 24-year-old?
Uh-huh. So,
I'm sorry.
In New York City, in the great city of Harlem, PS 194, third graders. PS in New York is public school, which is elementaries, okay? So, public school 194, third grader. One fifth grader. 2 third graders attack another third grader sexually. Let me tell you how. They grabbed the boy in the hallway. He was going from one class to another. They grabbed him in the hallway, pulled him into the bathroom, y'all. They made this little boy, this little 8-year-old little boy, get on his knees and give each and every one of them fellatio.
I don't want to hear this.
So what that means is that they mama and daddies all need to be in jail because they saw that somewhere. That is not a situation.
This was their form of bullying. They said they had been bothering this boy for a while.
It's not just the parents that need to do something. Those kids need to be locked up somewhere.
Pulled the fifth grader because he was the ringleader. He was the main one. And earlier in the year, because this is now at the end of the school year. So it was back in the early part of June, because in New York, they just get out at the end of June. So earlier in the year, this same fifth grader got in trouble in class for going underneath this girl's skirt and pinching her rear end. And she told nobody. The principal didn't do anything. Nobody did anything. The teacher just bad boy and kept it moving. The same boy turned around and attacked a third grade boy.
He has some mental
and
issues.
And they put him on his knees. The boy said one of the third graders held him with his arms behind his back.
This.
The other one pushed him down to his knees. And they all pulled out their things and had that little boy, fellatio.
You know, exactly.
Yeah. Well,
he,
I mean, that's
bit him.
That's there's, crazy.
There are some things, like I said, that's a situation where they...
I just
in the fifth and
the
third grade, you don't really know what's going on with that stuff. So it's just one of those things. So
that's not no one of those things. That boy need to be.
When I say that's one of those things that's a learned behavior at that age. That is not an inherent behavior.
But what the heck is she? What is she supposed to do now? Her third grader has been forced to freaking give fellatio to three boys. But yeah, he didn't even know. You know what I'm saying?
Let's have that discussion on hold. We need to have a psychologist in for that one. But I'm going to let you guys close out while I get ready to shut the show down.
Okay.
Are we done talking about this? Because I can't do this. I can't.
That just messed me up. I read the whole. It messed me up. Now, the fifth grader, they did pull out of the school. And the two third graders are on. Wait, suspension. This is my point. Suspension. They get suspended for 5 days. Five days suspension. That's crazy.
Okay.
All right, y'all. So
now it's time to close. But
now that I've made everybody's hair stand up.
I know, right? You got to leave that on that note. You know.
We love y'all and appreciate y'all for hanging with us.
Well, we got to
go. The food at Ozio's was really good.
Yes.
Little Ozio's is the bomb. Shout out to the manager.
Especially
the one on Moreland Avenue. And all the little Ozio's of Atlanta.
You know, I had the bruschetta, and I had the Caesar salad with the salmon on top of it.
I love
it
the fettuccine Alfredo.
My son had a pizza. Where did my son go? Oh, he's in the car.
And all that other wonderful stuff that was ordered. So we love y'all, little Ozio's. Food is always awesome.
We can't wait to come back. You know, have some fun.
We want you guys to make sure you are staying tuned to our Facebook page so you will know what's going on.
Yeah.
And also our Twitter page if he decides to twit.
Tweet.
Oh, I know. That's what he said.
And so also, you know, we need some feedback. I guess we're going to have a poll on when we should do the show again.
Yes.
But, you know, we want to hear from you. So
yes,
talk
go to the UAT Facebook page, Urban America Today. Like it and then go ahead and let us know your thoughts
and
comments.
Oh, and here's my son. I want to introduce my son. So come here real quick.
Come over here, son.
Come here, son.
This is the one who has the money jars.
This is my son. Hello. See?
You can sit right here.
Oh, sit right here.
Hilarious.
Okay. This is my child.
Hello.
Say hello to everyone.
Hello, everyone.
We should do a talk show with me and my son.
Oh, my
gosh. You know, that would be really awesome. I'm sure we would have a lot of things to talk
about. Hilarious. But in the meantime, we're going to close out this one.
Yeah, we got to close this one out. We got to say goodbye.
So
it's so nice.
Yes.
I'm so glad we had this time.
Together. Okay. Good night, John Boy. Good night, Grandma. Good night, Grandpa. Good night, Elizabeth, and all you other people out there. So we will see y'all next time. Make sure y'all checking out the Facebook page again, Urban America Today, or continue to check the website at myjbn.com /UATATL.
Hey, find me, Tara Jackson.
Time. Oh, yes, and check
www.TaraJackson, TaraJackson.com. Check me out.
And y'all know I'm Shantae, chosen by him. That's God. Coleman, and I will always be on Facebook. And you can Twitter me at The Real Shantae.
Peace.
Love y'all.
Love you, deuces.
Right. Roxanne.
Deuces. That ain't me.